What's up, y'all? It's the Macho Night. It's time for another one. So, Star Wars. The Rise of Skywalker. Sorry. The Rise of Palpatine. Let me correct myself. It's like, their persistence is ridiculous. Like, they persist on trying to make people think or feel some type of joy or hype behind this movie, especially behind Rey. Because now, and this is from Screen Rant, there's an article up here that says Star Wars confirms Rey breaks the Skywalker curse. What? I mean, we're gonna go through this real quick because I did a quick once over on this. I'm not gonna go through the whole thing. If you wanna check out this whole thing, it might make your brain hurt because it kinda like just a few things I went through kinda made my brain hurt a little bit. But anyway, let's check it out. It says the official canon Star Wars comic suggests to be a Skywalker is to embrace death, which means Rey was the one who finally broke the curse. But she's not a Skywalker. Not a Skywalker. Claiming a name doesn't make you a Skywalker. But we're going to get into that because they're just trying to make people care about this people in a movie that nobody liked. Oh, well, some people liked it. That's a bit much. But some people did like the whole trilogy. I'm happy for you that you're able to embrace trash and feel happy about it, but I can't. So let's check it out here. It says this week Star Wars number 5 suggests Rey has broken the Skywalker curse. Lucasfilm is rightly criticized for the lack of planning, much lack of planning, when it came to the sequel trilogy. As an example, although the Lucasfilm president Kathleen Kennedy initially tried to pretend Palpatine's resurrection had been in the works from the beginning, it didn't take long for that claim to fall apart. It was actually the brainchild of J.J. Abrams, who seems to have come up with the idea shortly after signing for the Star Wars Rise of Palpatine movie. This serves as a perfect illustration for the problem that can be seen throughout the trilogy, with the contrasting visions and studio-mandated course corrections given the film's disjointed feel. Yeah, and it's not helping. Again, what do we call the Disney version of the EU? The explained universe. That's what it is. It's not expanding upon anything. They keep trying to fix things. This is one thing that does appear to be planned, however, is the key scene at the end of Star Wars Rise of Palpatine, in which Rey claims her Skywalker surname. The art of Star Wars Rise of Palpatine includes a transcript for the meeting with Lucasfilm Story Group in 2004, roughly a year and a half prior to the release of Star Wars The Force Awakens. And this is where I was talking about. When they try to, mix and match everything and just throw it in there and throw a pot and then stir it all together and throw it up against the wall and see if it sticks. This right here, it says, I like the idea of she's going to be our Skywalker, Pablo Hidalgo observed in the meeting. But she's not a Skywalker. Then for our purposes, Skywalker is really a metaphor. It doesn't have to mean anything that's directly connected to blood. And this is where you lose everybody. Or at least the people like myself, people in the fandom menace and, people actually like Star Wars and like the Skywalker family. You guys are trash. I'm trying to not do this, but this annoys me to no end. Stop trying to make this feel something about Rey. Stop it. Get some help. That's what you need to do. Just stop it. Because it's ridiculous. Alright? Look, she is a Palpatine. There was no curse on the Skywalkers. What it was is Anakin was manipulated by Palpatine. Palpatine is evil. He wanted to destroy the Sith. It was a 1,000-year plan to destroy the Jedi. I'm getting furious over here. He wanted to destroy the Jedi. It was a 1,000-year plan that started from Darth Bane, and he was the culmination of all that. And he twisted Anakin into joining him. Curse? No. Folly? I would say more of that. More of a folly. And what was the curse on Luke's end? Other than the fact that you guys made him into crap. Because Luke was the hero. He was the one who brought his father back. What curse? Are you going to say, oh, the curse that Skywalkers go to the dark side? Is that what you're trying to say? But anybody can go to the dark side through manipulation. Right? And let's be clear. In the EU, which did it better, by the way, Jason fell to the dark side because he felt that he was doing something good. Which, like Anakin, but see, Anakin was really twisted into it, right? Like, Palpatine was like, listen, I can save your wife. I can save your wife. Come join me. I use the dark side. I'll help you save your wife. All the things that happen to your mother won't happen to your wife and your children. Right? Child. He didn't know he had two children at the time. But Jason, he went through it in a way where he, A, wasn't manipulated by it. I mean, you could probably say Lumaya kind of like threw a couple scenes, but Jason had a long path, like him getting caught by the Devon, you know, his teachings through, I'm drawing a blank on her name, the one captor who was a dark side user who was helping Devon. Her twisted teachings and turning pain and all the stuff like that. And then, obviously, with Lumaya, you know, putting the cherry on the top. Right? So, if you want to say that, but we still don't know. I mean, let's talk about Ben Solo, right? Right? I'm about to say Ben Skywalker because he's the real Skywalker. They still really don't say, oh, Luke tried to smoke his nephew, right? That was stupid. That whole concept, the whole thing of him going to the dark side was dumb. It's like, oh, we need somebody from the Skywalker bloodline to go to the dark side just to make it seem like all the Skywalkers go to the dark side. There was no point to that, right? So if you want to say the Skywalker curse was more or less like them going to the dark side, but what they try to do in this thing, and let's check this real quick. It was, we go down here to this thing here. It says, Darth Vader declares the truth, Skywalkers die. And this is their whole thing around this. It says, so, when Vader was looking for Luke, right? He had a bunch of people who were trying to, according to this, was trying to say, they were trying to, you know, puff themselves, say, oh, I'm Luke Skywalker, whatever. And these were all false people just trying to, you know, hype themselves up. And Vader says, he says, let all, you know, all basically some Skywalkers die. Essentially, to me, to somebody with a working brain, that to me sounds like, hey, stop trying to be a Skywalker. It's going to be your death. It's not some whole Skywalkers die curse. I don't know. I might be reading in this the wrong way, but I'm just furious about the fact that they constantly keep trying to push Rey. They keep changing things. They keep doing whatever they want. Bro, show's over. The show's over. I already told you how to get my attention again. You guys are not going to do it. Show's over. You got nothing. You got nothing for me. But anyway, how do you guys feel about Rey once again being put on a pedestal to be the one who outdoes Anakin, outdoes Luke, outdoes Leia, outdoes the entire legacy of the true Skywalkers in the EU because she's better than everybody else because she was written that way. Talk about what they call that. What's the armor plot, story armor plot? That's basically all Rey is. Like, this, it's like you watching that movie, you knew there was no way that she was going to get injured. There's no real stakes in it. Really none. But anyway, I'm going on a tangent. Let's wrap this up because I'm getting annoyed. How do you feel about Rey being the quote unquote savior of the Skywalkers yet again? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you can be missing the topic. Remember, you can't be good, you do that. Peace. I heard that the best bet is Monopoly. Ain't no exposure, show debt from assets to bets. I stand.